We don't have it yet. So we haven't really set a time. But what we need some help from you folks, especially you members. So that we can sell tickets. We need you to tell us if you can think you can sell some tickets. If you think you can sell some tickets for it, let us step back here in the back, give somebody your name and your phone number, and let them know, that you think you can sell some tickets. And we'll get you some tickets that you can sell to your friends and neighbors, the people that you work with. It'll be over here in Conway. So if you work in Conway especially, I know how Southern people are about their chicken bog, and stuff. So a lot of times people take a bunch of tickets, they'll sell them to the people that they work with, but we need some people to sell some tickets. We need some people to come over and deliver chicken dinners, because sometimes we'll get a factory or something where somebody will buy, the people at the factory buy 20, 30 chicken dinner or chicken bog dinners, and we take them to them and things like that. So if you think you can sell some chicken bog, or help us out in preparing the chicken bog and things like that, just step back there, give somebody your name and your phone number so we can get in touch with you. Because, this is some, and there's some people that have given very generous amounts of money toward buying the chicken and the rice and all the other ingredients for that. And if we've not quite got enough to buy it all, but if you've got some money you'd like to give so we can finish helping, that sure goes a long, long way to helping Rivertown, make our bills and pay the bands and just survive. So if you can do some of that, we certainly would appreciate it. Just step out there, give them your name and your phone number so they can get in touch with you whenever we decide exactly when we're going to do it. And then we'll get in touch with you and tell you what you can do, or if you've got some money you'd like to give us to help out with purchasing the ingredients for the chicken bog and stuff like that. Okay. Now, I tell you, I've been all boogered up all night, tell me you're going to do 3 songs, you do 2 songs, and then you tell me you're going to do another song. And now we got to entertain back up here again, so I understand we got a special request for Nick to do something right now. So ladies and gentlemen, we're going to turn Nick loose. Nick, let her rip.
We're going to do just a piece of it here. We had a request for it, so we're just going to do it maybe once or twice through, and hope you enjoy it.
Bluegrass and do a great job, and Nick is as far as I'm concerned, he's one of the greatest fiddle players I've ever heard, and I've heard some of the best and everything, but we certainly enjoyed any time he cuts loose on that fiddle. And hey, everybody still having a good time?
Yeah.
All right. Hey, listen, don't forget Antertown Bluegrass is playing over Socastee United Methodist Church right there just the other side of the drawbridge there in Socastee tomorrow at 4 o'clock. What time is the show at the library Thursday night? 6 o'clock at the Carolina Forest Library at 6 o'clock Thursday night. So you'll want to step over there and see that. All right. Hey, we got our feature band coming up now. Hang on just a second. Okay. We would like to make sure we've got everybody's email address. This ugly guy in the red shirt right here, You just walk around till something scares you, and that's the guy to give your email address to. So, and everything like that. But listen, he has really taken the bull by the horns, trying to get everybody's email addresses so we can get newsletters and messages out to Rivertown Bluegrass members and just friends of Rivertown Bluegrass, even if they're not a member. But make sure he gets your email address before you leave if we haven't got it. That way we can notify you of anything going on as far as Rivertown Bluegrass Society goes. We would certainly appreciate that. Okay? Okay, come on out, guys. You ready to roll? How many of you have seen this band before? All right, yeah, you're getting ready to hear some good old traditional bluegrass coming here. We ain't gonna hear any of that red tail ring and some of that other stuff they play on Bluegrass Junction these days. But anyway, yeah, well, listen, I don't know about you guys, but I'm all for traditional bluegrass music. And this band here, when it comes to traditional bluegrass music, they're as good as it gets. Are you guys ready to roll, or you need a sound check?
We're ready.
You ready to go? Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our feature band. It's Hubert Lawson and the Bluegrass Country Boys.
She lived in a cabin on a hill in a coal mining town in West Virginia. I'm the Jenny, and I guess always will. Virginia, you have won my heart and soul.
Back at Rivertown again. It's been a while since we was down this part of the country. Almost, as a matter of fact, it's been exactly a year. What did you tell me the second song was going to be?
I'll Remember Your Prayers.
It's one that lead us, yes. You might think it's a gospel song, and it probably is. It's a little thing called I Remember You in My Prayers.
Back by the stars, and the beautiful moon sweeps the sky. Dear drop from heaven are kissing the rose. It's thin that your memory upon the wings of a beauty. Listen, it's smashing your cheer. I'll give you a kiss of affection. I remember your love in the prime. As the angels of heaven are guarded, I'll send you all my sorrows and care. When it's night, when I kneel by my bedside to pray, I remember your love in my prayer. When it's night, when I kneel by my bedside to pray, I remember your love in my prayer.
Yeah. Yeah, see if you can do something for the bass. That's just a little bit. I can't hear it. And also, it's got a little rumble in it at times.
Without the tender love we share, and it's only sure my heart never truly cared. Well, I'm glad that it is over now. I'm glad that we are through. One tear is all I cry for you.
One tear don't make heartache. One tear won't make heart break. If the tear I shed today, it's all I have to pay. One tear is all I cry for you.
Sorry about that. Technical difficulty. Now it's on. We're gonna redo that one. Little thing called One Tear.
Happy life again, I'll have my dreams come true. Hop my ass right back in
Thank you. Ooh, they call one tear. Do I? Okay, we're going to slow it down a little bit. I guarantee you, we're going to. They're about to run me crazy. Anyway, this little thing called Till the River's All Run Dry. Thank y'all. We're going to turn him loose on the banjo tune here that Mr. Scruggs done back years ago. As a matter of fact, about all these tunes that you've heard tonight, Scruggs played them sometime or another. Anyway, this is a little thing called the Foggy Mountain Breakdown. Thank you. He sort of likes that tune, and I do too, really. I'm gonna sing you an old country tune. If I can find where I'm supposed to be. Kick it off for me. This thing around so much here that I done wore 15 out this year. Any of you folks, if you like what we're doing, we are on Facebook a lot, and we also got a band schedule out there in front where we're going to be appearing for the rest of the year. We've been lucky enough for the last 3 or 4 years, I want to mention these shirts that we've got out here. We've been lucky enough for 4 years to go down and do a Doyle Lawson and Quicksilver show for the Cancer Center there in Madison, North Carolina. We've done it for 4 years, and this year they had a few of those shirts left over, so I told them I'd bring them down here, and the funds go to the Cancer Fund. So anything that's sold here tonight, not my CDs, my CDs I take. But the shirts and things, they get that. What did you say we was going to do? There is a time. Thank you. Thank y'all. We're going to do you an instrumental thing here that we did on our last CD. It's a gospel song, and we did it as an instrumental. And I enjoy hearing these boys pick it. Maybe y'all will like it. Hope you do. Anyway, it's a little thing called How Great Thou Art. Thank you. Let me take a second and introduce all these guys over here playing for you. We don't have any idea who this is in the back here. We'll tell you about the rest of them. Playing the banjo and singing 95% of the lead for the Bluegrass Country Boys. He's been with me since day one. Since 1980. That's my oldest son, Lee Lawson. Y'all make him welcome if you would. Yeah. And anyway, always run around tuning that mandolin. He said he does that because he cares. He wants it tuned up right. So I told him buy him one in tune and stay that way. Anyway, he does a good job on the high tenor and singing the, playing all the mandolin except when he, you know, he gets a little messed up and I'll take it away from him and play it and he'll go to cry and I'll give it back to him. That's my youngest son, Eddie Lawson. Y'all make him laugh. And back on the doghouse bass, that there is Mama. Let me tell you what, I got a, on that latest CD we done, one of my friends done the insert in the thing, and it says on there, if Mama's not happy, nobody's happy. And that's about the darn truth, too. So y'all make her welcome, Miss Vera Ann. Okay. We're going to do what that these guys did a while ago, but we do it a little bit different than what they did. We're going to do you a little song here that the Boyd Brothers up in Mount Airy showed me how to play years ago. It's an old Grandpa Jones song called Fallen Leaves.
Y'all ready?
Yeah. And the man doing the talking for us here this afternoon.
They don't want
to know me. He picks lead guitar and sings baritone and... And like I said, he'll know anybody in the crowd. Y'all walk up to him. As long as you got some food in your pocket, he's ready to talk to you. When the food runs out, he's ready to move along to the next one.
What's wrong with that?
Just ask Bobby out there. Bobby says, you know, he all the time carries a ham biscuit in his pocket, so Daddy will stop and talk to him for a little bit. Anyway, stand up, Daddy, so everybody can see you.
I'm already standing up, sir.
We call him the shortest man in bluegrass, Mr. Hubert Lawson.
Thank y'all.
Take it crazy, sir. The feelings that a good deed brings until
back to your grave. There's no use taking any gold. You can't use it when it's time for hands to fold. And when you leave this life, what better home someday? The only thing you'll take is what you give away.
Thank y'all. I want to introduce my the guy sitting back kind of on the left-hand side, back kind of about halfway back. Look at him looking around. He knows who I'm talking about. He is our official bell player in the band. And how lucky can one man get? He left it at home tonight. Anyway, when he ain't, you did leave a thunder drum home too, right? He usually, if he leaves a bell at home, he usually brings that thunder drum. And two or three times we've been playing, he thundered up a rainstorm. And that ain't good, especially if you're playing outside. Anyway, he'll correct. Hey, if I say something wrong, he'll correct me. What are you doing? Sally Gooden. I used to do a guitar break on that, but they got away to play it so slow, I don't want to fool with it. Anyway, I also ought to mention that Bobby, my bell player's wife's back there with him. Listen, if she hadn't bring him down here, he wouldn't know how to get down here. Hang in there, Bobby. You all right? He's about as good as gold. What are we doing?
Pretty pot.
Oh, Lord.
President Mickey.
That's
Lord.
Lord.
This is special Mickey.
I'm
going to try to remember all the words.
All of them, too, now.
I'm going to try my best.
We need a boat anchor. Throw it around his arm while you slow down a little bit. Eddie, what are you doing sweating so much back there? Y'all see him? He's not cool, calm, and collected like me. Anyway, this is one of my least favorite songs. But these boys like it, and a lot of people do like it, we'll attempt it. An old Ralph Stanley number, a little thing called Pretty Polly.
Oh, Polly, pretty Polly, would you take me? Oh, Polly, pretty Polly, would you take me? Sit down beside you, I'll tell you my mind. My mind is to marry you now. Hey! frozen and white as snow.
Three verses. Now listen, I wasn't sweating till he done nothing. Now I am. Okay, indeed. We're gonna let him sing you one that that Paul Williams and the Victory Trio did one time. We enjoy hearing him sing this one. This old, old house.
There's an old, old house that once was a mansion on the hill overlooking the town, where time is living, where once there was beauty, and soon the old house. When the leaves begin to fall in the autumn and the rain drops the shit from the tree, that's an old man who walks in the garden and his head is bound in memory.
Anyway, we appreciate these fellas inviting us down to pick for you today, tonight. We enjoy it everywhere we go. I mean, I love to eat, but I love to play music too. I appreciate the sound people back here. They're doing a tremendous job as always. Y'all give them a hand, because I tell you what, they work harder than we do. Because, hey, they got to be here about 3 hours before I get here. They got to be here about 3 or 4 hours after I leave, getting it all out and everything. But anyway, this is a little tune.
Merle?
Don't, hey, back up there, boy. I ain't done I ain't done talking yet, so back up. Anyway, this little thing called Reuben's Train. That train at, but it's pretty quick. Oh, you got it from Reuben? Well, I was dead gone. Anyway, let me tell y'all a little joke about, well, it's not a joke, it's the facts. Me and Mama got married years ago. I ain't gonna tell you how many years, it's been a right many though. Back at that time, I was working in public works and she wasn't. So, I come home one afternoon and she's sitting on the back porch crying. And I said, "What in the world is wrong with you?" And she said, "Well, I cooked the first pan of biscuits for you a while ago and set them out here on the porch for to cool, and a dog ate them." I said, "Don't worry about it, we'll get another dog." It was quite a while before I got any more biscuits. Let's do the we're going to try you one that that me and Eddie will kick down here if he gets it, if I get in the right place. We move around so much, it's hard for me to keep straight. It's a little thing that the Osborne Brothers done called Beneath Still Waters.
I'm ready when you are. One.
The surface won't tell you how even a fool could see that soon you'll be leaving me. But each and every heart share their turn and misery. This time it's me, and I'll crawl on beneath the waters. Your love is gone beneath the waters. Your love is gone.
Thank y'all. Thank all beneath still waters. Y'all seen me pick that, didn't you? I'm gonna pick another one now, and I'm gonna tell you something. The facts. If you'll watch closely, my fingers will never lose my hand. They'll stay right there the whole time. But anyway, some guy was mentioning it to him a while ago. We played it during the warm-up session, and he heard it out there in the hall, and he wanted to know. Said they played it too, and wanted, Eddie done run that sweat off on me. Did y'all see him? Anyway, he said that that they played it also, but they didn't play it in the same key we did. And I said, don't make no difference if you play it in the key you want to play it in. I'd prefer to play it in C chord, but these boys don't want to, so I play what they want. Anyway, this is an old Carter family song. Now, y'all watch my fingers. They'll never leave my hand. Called a wildwood flower.
Well, I'm going to play on that. I can't reach that now. I can't reach it.
Y'all ready?
Yeah.
He said he wanted to play another instrumental thing that he does on that banjo while he's got it in his hands. Got trick pegs on it, so he, a little thing called Home Sweet Home. Anybody ever heard that song?
Oh, yeah.
I believe it's been around about as long as I have, and I've been around about as long as dirt.
Yes, sir.
Still
dirt.
D. Thank you. little thing called Home Sweet Home. Did y'all notice we mashed him strings a bit, got away from the trick pegs? I showed him all that back years ago. No, Bobby Atkins. Any of y'all familiar with Bobby Atkins? Used to play with Bill Monroe. Bobby showed him how to do that on a banjo. I've never seen, but I think there's three guys I know that do that. I've never seen nobody else do it. Bobby and him and what's that? Who?
Troy
Bromlin. Used to play out of Roanoke. What are we doing next?
He's just like you.
Just like me? Yes. Okay. Just like you.
He's been a farmer all his life. He had slowed down when his heart broke down. He went under the surgeon's knife. And the four kids that he raised all lived so far from home. His wife died last December. Hector.
Thank you. Mama said I better straighten up and fly right. If didn't, I was going to walk home. And y'all know where Reesville's at. It's a long way home, so I guarantee you I'm going to be straight.
You don't want to be walking on 501 either.
I'd probably get run over there before I got started, wouldn't I? What we doing? Okay. Eddie volunteered to sing one, and when he volunteers, we let him go. Because he usually don't volunteer for nothing. The only thing I can tell you he volunteers for, we used to run up and down the road on an old Greyhound bus, And out of the 5 or 6 years that we drove it, I quit driving it because the diesel fuel got so expensive I couldn't afford it. But anyway, the 5 or 6 times that we, the 3 or 4 times that it broke down, all the years we drove it, Eddie'd get his coveralls on before it stopped rolling good. And he'd tote me the tools the rest of the night till I got it running. And I asked him why he had to put his coveralls on to come back out and do that. And he said, "I don't want that grease all over my pretty clothes off of them old wrenches." But anyway, he'd tote them wrenches to me all night long till I got it back running, however long it took. What are we doing?
Hot corn.
Hot corn, cold corn. Thank y'all. Okay, we can do that. Okay, we'll do that one. We'll do. Y'all don't mind if you do a couple of gospel numbers along, do you? Because we enjoy doing that too. We're going to do you one that Doyle Lawson and Quicksilver did. No, Ralph Stanley did this one. Little thing called I Am the Man, Thomas.
Thomas, I am the man. They made me carry the cross, Thomas. I am the man. I am the man, Thomas. I am the man. Look at these pale scars here in my hand. Thomas, I am the man. They named me to the cross, Thomas. I am the man. I am the man, Thomas. I am the man. Look at these nail scars here in my hand. Thank you. my side, Thomas, I am the man. I died on the cross, Thomas, I am the man. I am the man, Thomas, I am the man. Look at your pale scarred hair in my hand. They bury me in the tomb, Thomas, I am the man. In 3 days I rose, Thomas, I am the man. I am the man, Thomas, I am the man. Look at your tail scar, hair in my hand.
Thank y'all. We're going to do you another gospel song. If y'all know it, join in and sing with us. Little thing that Doyle Austin and Quicksilver done called Help's on the Way. What key is that in, you know?
Key of C.
Key of C.
Yeah, way on that.
It's like, okay. I bet you ain't none of these fellas up here have done that. It's a little thing called a roving gambler. I know none of you's never gambled in your life.
Because
if you stop and think about it, it's against the law. Anyway, I'm just joking, folks. Don't pay no attention to me. Because I think the only door out is that way. And so if any of you's mad about anything, just say so, and I'll make a back door back. Anyway, this little thing called a roving gambler.
Many more weeks than three, when I fell in love with that pretty girl. She fell in love with me, fell in love with me, fell in love with me. To her party, she come with her fame, with love and a mother's ear. I love the gambling man, love the gambling man, love the daughter, how can you treat me so? Leave your dear old mother and with the gambler go. With the gambler go, with the gambler go. Oh, mother, oh, dear mother, you know I love you well. But the love I have for that gambler man, no human tongue can tell. No human tongue can tell, no human tongue can tell. We started out of Frisco, I wound up in Maine. There I met with the gambler man, we got the whole crew. Got the poker game, got the poker game. I put the money in the phone, dealt the cards around. Called him dealing from the bottom of the deck, so I shot the gambler down. Shot the gambler down, shot the gambler down. Down in prison, got a number for my name. One said, we're standing at the door, you gambled your last game. Gambled your last game, gambled your last game.
Thank y'all. We have, okay, we'll do that one. God, I'm really going to. Right.
That's the first time.
Bobby usually sits close enough. He counts them for me. And I'm supposed to be down seven. And a whole lot of times he'll stop me at five or six just to see if I'm on my toes. I'm on my toes tonight, Bobby. You don't need to count them for me. I got it. Anyway, I think he said we had time for two more. Yep. This is an old country gentleman number that I'm going to do. I enjoy their music. I mean, the country gentleman is A1 in my opinion. But anyway, this is a little thing called a Matterhorn.
We started out a barn one Friday August morning, just four of us. That was Albert Australian and John the Irishman. Oh, me and Bill from Britain, my dogs in the sun. Matterhorn, Matterhorn. Men have tried, men have died to climb the Matterhorn. Miles up, lost John, the rations fell below. Al and Bear were lying beneath an avalanche of snow. Now here I am alone, I know I could
Charleston. Oh, two more yards in front of me before I reach the town.
Man of war, red horn.
Men have tried, men have died to climb the Matterhorn, the mighty Matterhorn. Queen will surely knight me if I can get back down. It's closer here to heaven than it is back to the ground.
Matterhorn, Matterhorn.
Men have tried, men have died to climb the Matterhorn. The mighty Matterhorn. The mighty
one more. We've enjoyed being here tonight. If we've done anything you like with the Bluegrass Country Boys. If we did nothing you like, just don't mention it. Appreciate the folks coming by and buying our CDs out there that did. And we will stay around a little bit longer until they close the door to run us out. We've got about 6 or 7 different ones out there. So if you take an ocean, you want to take one of them home with you, be glad to let you have it because I've owned them long enough. Anyway, we've enjoyed all the music here today. Appreciate the folks that run this place. I'm sure they work hard all the month trying to get it set up to go. But anyway, this is an old Bill Monroe number. And remember, when we finish this, and I won't tell you, but remember, if you're driving, take your car. And also, don't run over no deer, because we can't do without any of them.
Thank you.
Hubert Lawson of the Country Bluegrass Boys. You're quite welcome. We appreciate you coming for us. I keep getting mixed up whether it's Hubert Lawson of the Country Bluegrass Boys or the Bluegrass Country Boys. Then I looked out there on the CDs and they got both of them on there.
So we get mixed up too.
So anyway, everybody had a good time tonight? All right, okay, we're not going to have a grand finale tonight because there's still some people over here jamming, and I think they've just decided they'd rather sit over there and jam, so you might want to just step over there on your way out. Listen for a few minutes. We got some door prizes to give away. I'm going to let Thomas take this microphone and give away the door prize, and I'm just going to run them out to whoever wins.
I lost Miss Vanna White. I don't know where she got this.